At the same time, the 12-member committee established to unlock the revenue-sharing stalemate will start sittings tomorrow to consider a proposal by President Uhuru Kenyatta to raise the county funds from 316.5 billion shillings to 366 billion shillings in the next financial year. Members of the committee have expressed optimism that the government pledge to increase the county funds will help members to find the elusive consensus. National Assembly will now be required to factor in the 366 billion shillings in the 2021-2022 Division of Revenue Bill to comply with the President's pledge. KTN News senior political reporter Patrick Amimo explains.
The Senate mediation team has promised to burn the midnight oil to reach consensus over the contentious revenue sharing formula. The President met the Senate leadership at State House Nairobi on Tuesday and promised to allocate an additional 50 billion shillings to counties in the next financial year, depending on the financial performance of the economy.
The 50 billion shillings, this will go a long way, basically, to ensure that no county loses in the county revenue allocation.
We have agreed in principle that no county should be affected in either way, either in gaining or losing in this financial year. This additional of 53.5 billion is a welcome relief, especially for some of us who have demanded our rightful share.
Senators were split in the middle over the new revenue sharing formula, where 18 counties, mostly in the marginalized regions, were to lose 17 billion shillings. In the last financial year, the Senate, National Treasury and National Assembly engaged in a long-drawn standoff when senators insisted that counties should be allocated 327 billion shillings, while the national government insisted on 310 billion shillings.
We had pushed for 335 billion. It is the Council of Governors who went behind our back as Senate and agreed to 316.5 billion.
And they said that why are senators wasting time? Give us this 316 and we'll be quite comfortable with it. But now we are happy that we have 360 billion.
Despite the Supreme Court of Kenya advisory opinion that the National Treasury can release up to 50% of the last financial year's allocation to counties if senators fail to resolve the impasse in the revenue sharing formula, Treasury is yet to invoke the decision.
And sought further advice from the Attorney General, who in this case has advised us, the only hope lies in the National Assembly, that the National Assembly can unlock this by carrying out, by sitting and giving direction to the National Treasury to disburse 50% out of the money that they have already appropriated. And to that effect, over 1 month ago, I have written to you, to the National Assembly, to ask, to request you to consider possibility of now giving us authority to disburse 50% of the resources.
We were in a meeting with the minister in charge of finance, with all the governors, whereupon it was agreed that the Supreme Court opinion is not an advisory opinion, but an order.
How will Parliament secure the president's pledge?
I know the economy is not doing as expected because of COVID pandemic and many other pandemics that have bedeviled the country, including corruption pandemic. Now the National Assembly have an obligation and duty on Division of Revenue Act now to ensure this 53.5 billion is reflected in the next financial year of 2021-2022 going forward.
Senators are expected to hold an informal meeting on Monday on the outcome of the mediation talks.
By the break of Saturday, we should be able to come up with a formula. And I am very sure when we come up with that formula, we shall blow the white smoke.
Patrick Amimo, KTN News.
You're watching KTN Prime, and our top story tonight. Governors have vowed to suspend services beginning